You keep telling me to make it, yeah, to the spot where we would stay lit, and finished bottles never wasted, yeah, 'cause that's where I'm from.
Welcome to Solano College Television Studios for another episode of On Campus. I'm your host, Stephen Babb. Today I'm joined by a special guest, Kevin Marks. Now, Kevin, why don't you tell our audience a little bit about what you do here at Solano?
Well, I'm a full-time tenured professor. I teach in two different departments, starting in kinesiology, and then I also teach in general psychology as well.
Awesome. You do some really interesting and amazing work, but before we get to that, why don't you tell us a little bit about how you got to be here at Solano?
Well, it's quite the story. I started out being an athlete competing in high school. If we want to go way back, I don't know if you want the long story.
Let us know.
But competed in all sports, all ball and stick sports in high school, three different sports, and ran some track, the fourth sport my senior year. And I really just love competing. I ended up playing 4 years of college football. And once I got done playing college sports, I came back and started teaching and coaching at the California Community College system at Modesto Junior College. And really just fell in love with it. It was so much fun working with these athletes and mentoring and teaching, being involved in football at the time when I just finished up. And I really enjoyed being in the classroom as well. And when the opportunity opened up about 5 years after that, getting that job in Modesto, the job opened here at Solano College. And it was funny, I remember when the job opened up, I put my name out there for about 18 different jobs in the area, actually in California. And I got one call back, and that was Solano College. So I came out and interviewed and thought it went pretty good, and got a call back and came to a final interview, and they offered me the job, and I really felt that I struck it big. At the time, I consider myself young. I was interviewing at 27. And it was really my dream job at the time. And I remember just telling my wife, I can't believe I got this great job. And I actually cried a little bit. And I came out right away and met with the athletic director and the dean and haven't looked back and have loved it ever since.
Sometimes all it takes is just that one break to kind of get you to where you've seen yourself and where you want to be. Now, you also hold two master's degrees and are still continuing your education today. Why don't you talk a little bit about that?
Absolutely. So out of the gate, I've been studying kinesiology, so bachelor's degree in kinesiology, and then I have a master's degree in sports science. And what that is biomechanics and exercise physiology. Also have sports psychology in there as well. And then my second master's degree is in general psychology.
That's awesome. And you're doing something with a coach from Seattle Seahawks?
Yes. Yeah, I've been really fortunate to get connected with Michael Gervais. He's the Seattle Seahawks performance psychologist who's licensed here in California as a psychologist. And I went down for about an eight-hour training down in L.A. and worked with him. I think there's about 15 or so people that had the opportunity to go down there as part of a screening and recording of a full course, mental skills course, that now they're opening up to the general public. It was once reserved for Fortune 500 companies and elite athletes. And so I've been doing that. I had opportunity to go down at that time, and really he just had a huge impact on me. And then just recently I was able to secure some academic grant funding, professional development funding, to participate in that mental skills course, which is an eight-week course training with him, Michael Gervais, and then also two Olympic athletes, Courtney Thompson and Nicole Davis. So it's been just a ton of fun working with some of the best thinkers and doers in the country.
Yeah, and I think that's really cool. And it's an interesting aspect of sports, especially professional sports, that I think a lot of fans out there don't realize that the sports psychology aspect of what you're talking about is huge, I think, now, especially in pro sports, that teams are starting to really kind of move towards. Now, you take that experience and you apply it here at Solano?
Absolutely. I apply it here, I apply it in my own life. Well, we try as best we can. And absolutely, it has an impact and it generalizes it across domains, we believe. And it's something that I feel has really helped out in a lot of different areas. It's a little different in terms of thin slicing it down to the general population with students. There's a lot of different ways that we can package that in, but it is certainly things that we apply when it comes to that.
And kind of just unlocking the mind and kind of helping prepare steps of thought to be successful. And, you know, young students here can take it from, you know, sports and really apply it later in life. What are some of the things that you try to teach the young students here at Solano?
That's a good question. And there's a lot of things. There's a lot of different layers and models and theories that we work with the students, whether it be a workshop or a certain class, like a sports psychology class. But I think the first way or first part where we start is the fact that what are the underpinnings or the barriers that get in the way of performance? For example, a student in a classroom, what is it that prevents them from being them in that environment? They might see that environment as rugged and hostile. So whether it's throwing their hand up, raising their hand in a class, they have an idea, they want to express themselves, all of a sudden that heart rate elevates and they might hesitate to throw their hand up and participate. Or it's their time to shine and they have to give a speech and they're walking up to the podium, and all of a sudden that just their natural pattern of thought becomes disentangled. And that is a problem, because that serves to limit that individual, that student, to play it safe and play it small. And so what we try to do is that we try to unpackage that. And so there's a lot of things going on, but there's usually three things that we look at when it comes to maybe a student or even athletes that might get in the way. So the first thing is we try to look and see is what are the barriers that are getting in their way. And one of them is a fear-based model. And the second is maybe fatigue. They're just so tired, they don't have the energy to sustain themselves, to learn the skills and apply themselves in those areas. And then the third, especially at this level, I believe, is time management. But the first one, the fear base, is really where we start. We start with that. And there's a lot of ways that we can go when it comes to how we dissolve some of that, mm-hmm. but that's where we would start.
Yeah, I've taken public speaking course here at Solano, and I've experienced it myself, and yeah. Definitely witnessed it amongst my classmates, that when you step in front of an audience, there's that anxiety that starts to build, mm-hmm. and you start to kind of feel afraid and unsure and not maybe have the confidence it takes to stand in front of a group and really kind of project yourself and your message. And in sports, you know, they say, you know, 80 or 90% of it's mental, and then the rest of it is your physical abilities, and to be able to kind of overcome those hurdles. And it sounds like you're really helping students, you know, get past those hurdles individually, what they have for themselves.
Yeah, that's the plan. And we hope that we're able to guide them. And the general assumption is that whether it's a student or an elite athlete, that they have what it takes already in themselves. And so our job, my job as a mental skills performance coach or whatever endeavor we're in or domain, whether it's a teacher, is to get them, not get them, but to invite them and inspire them to reveal their own insights and wisdoms that allow them to be them, you know. And so with that, what we do is we try to kind of pull apart and tease apart some of those areas where they become disentangled. And like we've already talked about. Mm-hmm. So one of the things is we look at just basic interpretation of physiology. Athletes are pretty good at this. You know, when the lights are on and it's ready to go, they interpret that physiology, whether it's heart rate, elevation, respiration goes up, breathing, the hands start to shake, whatever it is, they might interpret that as, okay, I'm getting switched on. You know, it's time to shine. And so the first thing we look at is try to appraise that, you know, with these students in the classroom, that it's okay, we're all like that. As soon as you take your first few steps up the podium, that means you're switching on, and that's a good thing. And so then we use other tools to be able to dissolve some of that, because, you know, generating calm is the entry point into flow state. So there is some things we want to do with that. The first thing is to work on how we interpret that. And then the second part is nothing's really changed, you know? I mean, there's two ways we can look at it. One is that everything's different. It's a big moment, big event. We have cameras, lights, it's big. And what happens is sometimes when we interpret that as big, we play small because we feel that it's over the top for us. We're not ready. And that could be valid, you know? So there's ways to train that too. If we work from that model, we have to train to be big. So we have to artificially throw in ways to train. You know, and so if it's athletes or let's say students, mm-hmm. then it sounds, you know, it's interesting because if they want to play big, they have to do big things. So they have to get their heart rate up, and it sounds kind of silly, but push-ups, jumping jacks, jogging in place for 5 minutes, and then getting in front of a camera or stepping up to the podium, because that's a physiology that's probably going to mimic that environment.
Yeah, and I think especially amongst athletes, you know, they may feel that turn on but not understand the different aspects of it. You know, why am I feeling this way? What exactly is working and going on? And I could see how that would be beneficial to even non-athletes and students to just have that understanding of why am I feeling this apprehension, maybe, and recognizing how to deal and use it to your advantage. Because I think,
yes,
and I've experienced, you know, how to, okay, my heart rate's going, everything's moving, like, okay, this is what I need to do, and almost turn that anxiety into an excitement.
There it comes across
in conversation, and, you know, like big lights and cameras, but what you and I are doing here is just having a conversation.
Sure.
So if you kind of can tune out everything and just focus, you know, not just internally, but just kind of make it a little bit smaller between us and not kind of hear the outside noise, I think it definitely has at least help me in this conversation.
There you go. And that's it right there. It's cultivating awareness around what model that you work with or from, mm-hmm. and the same thing with students. And there's many ways to train. That would be one of them. And another one is to look at it as just another event or another moment.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's all the same.
So for students out there that are watching this episode of On Campus, what particular courses are you involved in right now, and maybe some workshops that you have ongoing or coming up?
Sure. So the gist of my schedule is geared around psychology, sports psychology. So mm-hmm. I usually teach one or two of those a semester, or a health class, and those are online. Okay. And then I teach general psychology, introduction to psych 001. And then let me see, the other classes is maybe a yoga class.
Okay.
And then I also work with student athletes. So the athletes, I work with the soccer team as a high performance mental skills coach.
Very cool.
And then the workshops I've given about the last 2 years, there's been some workshops that I give on high performance psychology, sharing some of the insights and wisdoms that I've come to understand from some of the highest level performers or sport psychologists that are out there. And we decouple some of these things that we've talked about today and really drill down on the student. And what does it take for them, again, to be them, to be their most authentic self in that environment?
And all this information, I assume, can be found on My Solano,
yes.
The Solano College mm-hmm. website?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. You know, I really have enjoyed this conversation. I appreciate your time today. And it's a really cool to learn that Solano has you as a resource here to kind of help with this kind of mental challenges that not just athletes, but all students can face, especially as a young adult, getting going in life and learning about themselves. So it's been really cool. I appreciate your time today. And that's going to do it for this episode of On Campus. I'd definitely like to thank my special guest today, Kevin Marks. And for Solano College Sports Network, I'm Stephen Babb.
The exponential growth from the program from my first year to my third year now, that's what keeps me coming back and keeps me excited and just like fulfills me as a person.
It's so impressive, and we every time we walk in here, you guys are doing something different. It's great. It's
nothing but opportunities here, and we have sports to cover, we have the equipment.
Because the more ambitious you are, the more opportunities you'll have.
On-the-job training is huge.
Get the hands-on experience.
When someone asks who can do it, you know, you can raise your hand and say, I can do it, so.
Joining the class was the best decision I ever made.
To Audrey Jones. Audrey for three! It is good! With 1.3 seconds left on the game clock, Audrey Jones with one of the biggest shots ever.
The sky's the limit, really, with what we can do here.
College just got affordable. Up to 100% of enrollment fees can be reimbursed for first-time college students taking full-time classes. At Solano Community College, we are taking full advantage of this to further your future. With certificate and degree programs in industrial technology, aeronautics, biotechnology, and many others, Solano Community College is a staple for success. For more information, please contact the Financial Aid Office at 707-864-7000.